Evening, YouTube. Parson Rick here. It's Monday, December 7th. Doing a VR for Erk Pik. So, remember Pearl Harbor history for today. In Erik's contest, he asked two things. One was, what got you into pipe smoking? And like a lot of folks, my forebears smoked. My great-grandfathers and my grandfathers smoked pipes, some of them, and my father chewed cigars, and I grew up playing with their discarded pipes. And as I got older, I started searching for connection, I guess, and I had always thought that when I was old and a curmudgeon, I would take up pipe smoking. So there we are. I did that. Also, on the history note, we're talking favorite periods of history, and like a lot of Americans, especially us West Coasters, my antecedents are a little sketchy. And among my forebears, my ancestors, I know occasionally bits and pieces of people. I found out that I am related to Peregrine White, not Peregrine Took, Peregrine White, who was the first white child born on this continent, according to Mayflower and all that. Believe what you want about any other stories, I don't care. And I know a few of my ancestors, but one whole side of my history is real sketchy. And I have a grandmother who was Cherokee and a great-grandmother who was Blackfeet. And at the end of the 19th and the start of the 20th century, it wasn't very cool to be an Indian. First Nations, whatever you want to call it. And so I've always been very interested in that aspect of my history. And I know that my first Oregon Trail ancestors that came over were the Carters, Smiley Carter. I ran across his tombstone. Up north of Albany, there's a little town called Palestine, and there was an old pioneer cemetery there. I've knocked my pipe out of my hands twice, and it says there's a big obelisk, and it says that Smiley Carter came from Illinois in 1846, and I'm a descendant of his younger brother. And so, for a lot of us out here on this coast, anyway, whose families have been here, my family's been in Oregon 5 generations, a lot of us don't really know what or who we're descended from. I know my mom's dad and his parents, but before that, no idea. No idea where they're from or who they were. They showed up, and here I is. So, very interested in the latter part of the 19th century and all the migration. Hunter S. Thompson, in his book on the Hell's Angels, he wrote in 64, 65, he lived with them down in California. And he was trying to explain the phenomenon of wild people. To white bread America. And he had a very interesting statement in there, paraphrasing. He said, for thousands of years, the unhappy have been moved from Africa up across the Mediterranean into lower Europe, up across the Atlantic Ocean to the East Coast, and then bumped all the way across until finally they hit the Pacific Ocean. And what you have are 100 generations of the restless sons boiling. And I'm certainly one of those. No idea what my history is. And I think that's probably why I'm interested in it, because a lot of history, especially for us that have Native American roots, we're all born here, so we're Native Americans. We don't know. So I just had recently found out that one of my grandmothers, my great-grandmothers, was Blackfeet. And my wife and I happened to be up in Browning, which is where the tribal headquarters are. And I bought a pipe, a real pipe. And I was going to light it, but boy, that took off. And this is a pipe, and it's made from the official, it's made by Betty Gerbing Tellinghouse. It's carved from Pipestone, and it's official. This is a genuine Indian handmade craft. So I picked one of these up. This is technically my first pipe, and I have not smoked it. So I was going to do that for Erk on this video. I hope that's okay. So I have my Pipestone authentic pipe filled with Potlatch, Seattle Club Potlatch. I thought that was appropriate. I'm going to light it with cedar. Just try to be all Aboriginal here or whatever. And of course, this was just burning so much I had to put it out. So excuse me while I relight the wood. No, I don't know how to edit this stuff out. Sometimes with the cedar, it takes a bit. So, this has a monster big hole in it, so it draws very well. Like halfway down your throat. So, Erk, congratulations on your subscribers, and glad I subscribed to you. Hope to get to know you a little bit, and all of you lost souls out there, like me, trying to find who we are and where we came from. Half the time, I just take the story that appeals the most. Can't get this stinking cedar lit again. The bowl is very small, the diameter is tiny. I had to use one of the sticks. For a tamper. So, good luck everybody. Thanks for the opportunity to smoke my first pipe. I hadn't even thought about it. It was sitting in a different room. Oh, good night. God bless.